Hello, Tor Lacey here with an introductory discussion about distinguishing among rock types and the rock cycle. Our lecture objectives and learning outcomes include students use texture and composition to identify rocks and the origin of rocks. That's one of our course student learning outcomes. We also want to be able to describe the interrelationship among the three types of rocks using the rock cycle, and be able to distinguish between an igneous, sedimentary, and metamorphic rock. Three rock types are recognized on Earth: igneous, sedimentary, and metamorphic, each of which form through distinct geologic processes. Igneous rocks form when lava solidifies on Earth's surface or magma solidifies deep underground. Igneous rocks. There are two categories of igneous rocks: intrusive and extrusive. Intrusive igneous rocks form inside Earth, deep underground, and are characterized by coarse-grained crystalline textures, where mineral crystals are large enough to be recognized without a microscope. Cleavage surfaces may cause these rocks to sparkle in the light. The common rock granite is a good example of an intrusive igneous rock. Extrusive igneous rocks originate on Earth's surface, where lava quickly solidifies, giving mineral crystals only a short period of time to grow before the molten material has solidified. This results in rocks with a fine-grained texture. The most common rock to form in these conditions is basalt. In some cases, the lava may cool so quickly that no crystals grow before solidification has happened, resulting in the formation of volcanic glass. Sedimentary rocks form when eroded rock particles, sediment, or organic material are solidified into rock on Earth's surface through physical and chemical processes. Sedimentary rocks form on or very close to Earth's surface from minerals and rock that have been weathered and eroded from pre-existing rocks, where the eroded rock and mineral fragments, called grains, are deposited, then cemented together, clastic or detrital sedimentary rocks form. Grains are deposited in horizontal layers called strata. Sandstone, a rock that forms from grains of sand cemented together, is a good example of a clastic or detrital sedimentary rock. Non-detrital sedimentary rocks are generally not composed of grains because they form through a different process, which involves precipitation of mineral matter out of solution or from organisms, or through the accumulation of organic matter. Metamorphic rocks form when a pre-existing body of rock is altered beneath Earth's surface. Metamorphic rocks form when a pre-existing mass of rock is subjected to intense heat and pressure, and the original texture and/or mineral composition changes to adjust to these new conditions. This typically can only happen deep within Earth, so the origin for metamorphic rocks is always underground. Metamorphic rocks can be distinguished by their common foliated texture or sheen. Gneiss is a nice example of a metamorphic rock with foliated texture. The rock cycle shows how all three types of rock are interrelated and that any type of rock can become any other type of rock. For example, if a metamorphic rock is melted, it becomes magma that will eventually cool and solidify to become an igneous rock. Or if an igneous rock is subjected to heat and pressure, say because it was caught up in a subduction zone, it will transform into a metamorphic rock. We should also recognize that any type of rock can be broken down to become that same type of rock again in the future. For example, sedimentary rocks, when exposed on Earth's surface, will be subjected to the geologically destructive forces of weathering and erosion, breaking it down into grains. After these grains have been transported and deposited, they will eventually be cemented back into a sedimentary rock. Let's consider where the different rock types can originate using this illustration showing a divergent and convergent plate boundary. In this diagram, seafloor spreading allows for decompression melting of the asthenosphere, forming plutons of magma, which rise up and eventually solidify into intrusive or extrusive rocks. At convergent plate boundaries, subduction generates magma when water is released from the subducting plate, causing flux melting of the overriding asthenosphere. Plutons of magma rise, where they eventually solidify into intrusive igneous rocks, or are expelled onto the Earth's surface to form extrusive igneous rocks. Metamorphism of rock also happens along convergent plate boundaries, where compression causes tremendous heat and pressure, which causes the rock to be transformed into a metamorphic rock. As rock is uplifted above Earth's surface, it will begin to be broken down through destructive geologic processes. Sediment is transported to a place of deposition, like the seafloor, where it eventually is solidified into sedimentary rock. This is the end of this lecture. Thank you for listening.